welcome back to my Norman campaign. So I've taken a moment and I've looked at the strategic options here, and I realized that if I'm going to attack, which I should, if say for example I attacked this army here with Walter Giffard, or I attacked this army here with Guillaume Le Bataire here, the king of the Normans, I would not be using this unit at all. And it would be, well, it'd either be 3-on-2 or 4-on, or 3-on-3, and I want to have myself as much of a decided advantage as possible. This, in any case, this unit would not be used, the one led by William Fitz Osborne. So, I think I'm going to try swinging around and attack their right flank, my right flank first. And if I can get a decided advantage here, then I will have a bigger advantage in the main melee that is to come. So, what I'm going to do, I have one army already here, and I have these two armies here waiting to ambush. Now I have two places I can move, which will spring this ambush. Now if I go here, if I bring this army right here, William's army, and I bring him right here, this will spring the ambush, and I'll be 2-on-2, which would be fair, but there's an even better option, which is I would bring, William Fitz Osborne's army right to this point right here, would spring just the ambush of this guy, and it'd be 1 versus 2. So that's what I'm going to try and do, and let's see what happens, shall we? So I'm going to move him right there. Oh, and actually, the ambush was not sprung. That is even better. So now I don't even have to worry about being in a not so great situation. So what I'm going to do is, it'd be 1-on-2. So I have to bring this army up to spring. Aha! All right. So this is what happened when I brought this army out here. It looks like Leofwine Godwinson has come to try and ambush Eustache de Boulogne. So it looks like it's going to be a 1-on-1 battle there, and if I win that, then I could possibly have a 1-on-1 battle here. So looks like there'll be two separate battles. I'll see you on the battle map. So once again, I've been ambushed, and the front of my column, it has two forces of the enemy attacking on either side. Now, you might have noticed something a little bit different. I've taken away the arrow markers and the banners to create a more of a cinematic feel. Not because the banners and the, especially the arrow markers, are just beautiful in this mod. And I'm not getting rid of it for the sake of I don't like them. It's just for kind of aesthetics. I'm trying something out. If you guys kind of hate this look, then I'll revert it back to, where it was before. Alright, let's see here. What should I do? Well, first things first is I should get my Norman Knights here. My mercenary Norman Cavalry, actually. And I'm going to regroup them right here. I'm going to run them. And now, I have a lot of swordsmen that can kind of go toe-to-toe with some basic feardmen, I'm thinking. So, we're going to bring these ones to attack there, these ones to attack there, these guys to attack there, and these guys to attack. Select feared. They seem a little bit tougher, but I have to hold them off. Now, what do I have here? I have axemen. Alright, so they're going to assist in this particular push. Actually, I'll have this unit assist with this select feared right here. My archers are kind of just screwed. There's nothing I can do. Now I have these mercenary Flemish spearmen. Okay, so these mercenary Flemish spearmen, one can pin down the housecarls. This one here, I think it was this one next that hasn't moved, so we're gonna bring them there. We already did that one. Did I? No, I didn't. There we go. This one will also go to these housecarls. These ones will go here. And these ones will go here. Now, I'm going to run my general out and away so he doesn't get entrapped. And I'm going to try and do my best to move my poor archers. I'm going to just put them in a little bit more maneuverable blocks, and maybe there'll be a spot where they can run away properly. Alright, let's see how things go. The good news is that there aren't any woods, so my cavalry should have a bigger advantage. Okay, so... Alright, so I'm doing really well here. Not so great here, so... Let's... help out... these guys here at the front of the column. Let's see here. I might be able to sneak my archers out through this way. Let's try it. Now my general here. Let's see here. I know, I'll swing him around this way. Alright. How am I doing here? Yep, those archers didn't do so great. And my mercenary Flemish spearmen at some point are also fighting to the death, so this isn't going as well as I had hoped. But I still have my cavalry. And, yeah. Yeah, it looks like this... Okay, so this front half has crumbled. Okay, so they've broken. That's good. Okay, I'm gonna charge in here and bring this guy and these guys at around to take care of these house carls, because man oh man, they're gonna need as much help as they can get. Ah, house carls are attacking my cavalry. Who earns? Okay. Okay, so let's just take a look here. Looks like these feared men, these mercenary Flemish feared men are in a bit of trouble, so we're going to bring in my cavalry to help them out. What else do we have going on here? Housecarls and peasants on either side. So let's do a charge onto the back of these housecarls. Yes, excellent. Where's my archers? Have them keep hitting those housecarls there. These Lechfjord are chasing my archers, which is fantastic. If I can get them out of the battle, that's even better. Alright, so now my battle line is starting to look a little bit more solid, which is nice. Let's see here. Royal housecarls, they're also fighting. Let's disengage with them there. And have my infantry keep going for them. Alright. Let's zoom in on this little cavalry charge here, shall we? Very nice. So it looks like some of my Flemish spearmen aren't doing so hot. Alright, let's try to charge on this away. Can I recollect any of my previously routed units? They're fighting. What are these guys doing? Ah, nothing. That's kind of important. Oh, great. More like feared. Have gone after these guys here, but they're pretty much hooped. So we're going to have to just try to use my cavalry here as much as possible. I really need to break these guys here. So let's try to charge in there. Free up that flank, or that, well, it's more of just a giant hustle of stuff. Alright, excellent. I did end up breaking this line. Alright, so I need to bring these guys into the center, because I have a feeling that's where we're going to be meeting it pretty soon. So bring these guys in. Let's bring my cavalry, which has been invaluable in this fight so far. these guys aren't fighting anymore, so let's bring them in to help out their buddies on that far, far flank. Okay, so the peasants have broken, so that now opens up these royal house guards. Actually, wait, bring these guys here to get rid of these peasants. Okay, what's going on over here? Okay, so these guys have broken. Dagnabbit. Alright, so what's happened here? Ah, the enemy commander has fallen. I've killed Leo Flying Godwinson. So that's going to be a huge boon. Because my cavalry, I don't know how much more they could have taken. Let's see here. Who else is still fighting? These guys. Okay, I think everyone who can move is still moving. So we'll do that. Alright, so now I have to worry about these house girls. Now with their commander dead, perhaps I'll be lucky. And, that'll cause them to rout. Oh, they have routed. Oh, excellent. Oh, ho, excellent, excellent, excellent. Okay, so I need to chase them down. So I still have a unit of House Scarls here, and two units of House Scarls, and some Light Fear. So these guys have pretty much fled, which sucks. These guys are still fighting like crazy over here. I've actually broken those peasants. Wow, and I've broken these Light Feared. Wow, they actually won. Too bad I didn't get to see it. Alright, well, you guys can just keep chasing them, because you're too far off to make a difference in this final climactic little struggle right here. Alright, this is going to be tough, because I got major house scarls right here. God, where are these guys? Oh, crap, they're all the way over there. Well, that's not useful at all. Whoa, my general's in trouble. Oh, they've broken. Oh, crud. Uh-oh. Alright, wait, where have these guys gone? Alright. I need to bring these guys over here as fast as possible. Same thing with these guys. We're gonna have to just pray that my cavalry will regroup, which they have. So where do I need to strike them? They are slightly weaker here, so I'm going to have to charge them at that point. Extremely close. There we go. They're fighting to the death, which means they've broken. So now we need to bring this cavalry over here and get set for another charge. Let's just take a good look at this. There we go, I've routed those house girls as well. So let's send in this unit here to round up these house girls. So now, what units do I have left? Some Light Feared, which shouldn't be too much of a problem. Oh man, that was tough. That was extremely tough. There we go, so they've broken again. Excellent, so we're going to just round them up. Alright, so it looks like I won this battle, albeit barely. I'll see you on the result screen. So, that was an average victory. I had 25,888 kills with 1,644 losses. Oh, I wish it was just 600 losses. So I have a few more men remaining than the enemy. But the more important thing is that I killed Leofwine Godwinson, which I believe was Harold Godwinson's brother.